Thanks to the Me Too movement, we as a society have begun to discuss the importance of survivors telling their stories, but we rarely talk about how. After I was raped, I struggled to write about the trauma I had endured. Even as a creative writer, it felt like I was having to translate my experience into a different language. I became increasingly concerned about how readers would read my work and understand it. Writing about sexual violence felt daunting, frustrating, and demoralizing. But through my research, I found that the epistolary form offers up a way to write about these kinds of experiences that becomes empowering, legitimizing, and intimate, both for readers and the writer. Epistolary writing is a literary form that uses letters, journals, or diary entries to tell a story. The form is written in second person, often addressed to someone specific, a you. The epistolary form asks readers to take that place of a you. We read and write emails, letters, and text messages every day. The form is an intimacy we're familiar with, which makes writing it more comfortable and reading it that much more engaging. For example, when readers read Sally's letters to God in Alice Walker's 1987 novel, The Color Purple, they faced the fictional details of a young child being raped by her father. Before the 1970s, rape was often considered, quote, titillating and, quote, pleasurable, because fictional violence was often narrated from a perspective of a male rapist. The epistolary form allowed Walker's protagonist to have a voice and readers or survivors' perspective. In 2015, Ta-Nehisi Coates wrote to his own child in his memoir, Between the World and Me. Readers had to take on the you of his Black son as Coates described an education system that failed him, police violence, and the loss of Black life. The epistolary form asked Coates readers to imagine the kind of horrors that Black Americans have to face on a day-to-day basis. Therese Marie Mayotte published her memoir Heartberries in 2018. She said that epistolary work, quote, cuts out the contrivance. If you're familiar with somebody and writing to them, the reader themselves takes that journey and feels familiar as well. There's no setup. She asked her own readers to take the place of the you as she wrote letters about her experience as an Indigenous woman dealing with illness, violence, and grief. There's often an expectation of privacy when we write something to someone else, and yet the epistolary form invites readers to be a part of that privacy. It allows readers to engage with work surrounding violence in a different way than traditional narrative form does. And unlike writing other writing forms, the epistolary form allows for a response. Arguably, it encourages one. There's a space that assumes a letter could be written back. Through studying these works and their author's craft, I've been able to tell my own story, and not only that, but begin to facilitate a discussion that leaves room for my readers to write back.